Hello students, I want to welcome you to another social studies lesson. And in today's lesson, we want to cover several things such as rights and responsibilities of children, two, organizations that protect children's rights, and other organizations. So look forward for this lesson, and remember, you can subscribe to quick access to all the lessons and videos that will be posted. So to start today's lesson, we want to identify rights and responsibilities, but we're going to start with rights. What are rights? Our rights are what every human being deserves, no matter who they are or where they live, what culture, race, or religion. Some of our rights include: everyone has the right to have life and safety, education, shelter, which is somewhere to live, warmth, food, clothing, personal space, freedom of speech, to feel comfortable, equal opportunities, given a chance to be what you want to be, whether you are rich or poor, whatever religion or race. And everyone has the right to social services. What is a responsibility? A responsibility is something that is your job to do something about or to think about. It is something that affects our lives and other people's lives. So just as children has the right to education, they have the responsibility to make sure that they get all their work completed and finish on time. Then some of our responsibilities: to follow the rules at home, at school, and in the community. After all, they are there for our safety and to protect our rights and the rights of others, to stand up for our rights and the rights of others as much as we can. Responsibility to be the best person that we can be, to take care of our own bodies as best as we can, and to respect the rights of others, to look after our own belongings and respect the belongings of others, to learn as well as we can, to care about others who are not as strong in some ways as we are. So remember, children, you have rights and also you have responsibilities. Then we have a major organization, which is UNICEF. The aim of this program is to give children a best start in life. It supports national and community-based service providers to implement comprehensive child-sensitive policies and programs. All children have the right to be protected from violence. The aim of this program is to protect children from violence and abuse and to ensure that children are registered at birth. So remember, UNICEF, which is the United Nations Children's Fund, is a worldwide organization that protect the rights of all children. Then we have the National Organization for the Prevention of Child Abuse and Neglect, which is NOPCAN. And NOPCAN exists to assist in confronting the problems that occur in dysfunctional families. NOPCAN, which has traditionally addressed the issue of abuse, is now focusing its attention on prevention and how best the organization can reach out to those children who are affected. So remember, NOPCAN is an organization in Belize that look out for the welfare of children and children being abused. Then we have the NCFC, which is the National Committee for Families and Children. And the National Committee for Families and Children, Belize's lead agency for the promotion and protection of children and family rights, contributes to and advocates for policy and legal reform that influences a child-centered approach to development, which positively impacts the well-being of children and their families. So remember, NCFC looks out for children and their families. Then we have the NDACC, which is a National Drug Abuse Control Council under the Ministry of Health. NDACC's mission statement is to create a society free from the abuse of drugs while advancing the good health and moral well-being of the nation. This is a vision that it is striving towards. Then we have BAHA, which is the Belize Agricultural Health Authority. BAHA exists to serve Belize by providing efficient, competent, and cost-effective professional animal health, plant health, quarantine, and food safety services that protect human health, animal health and welfare, plant health and the environment, and ensure safe and wholesome food, strengthen national food security and facilities, trade and commerce. So remember, one of the main goals of BAHA is to look out for food safety and services for all Belizeans. Then we have the Caribbean Community CARICOM. The Caribbean Community CARICOM exists to promote economic integration between its members, to coordinate foreign policy objectives, and to ensure that the benefits derived through cooperation are shared in an equitable manner. The Caribbean Community CARICOM promotes trade between Caribbean countries. Belize is a member of CARICOM. Then we have the Organization of American States, OAS, and they exist to achieve an order of peace and justice, to promote their solidarity, to strengthen their collaboration, and to defend their sovereignty, their territorial integrity, and their independence. So remember, a good example of how the OAS is used. So if there is any issue between Belize and Guatemala, right away the OAS will step in order for them to try to solve the matter. Then we have the UN, which is the United Nations. And when Belize gained independence in 1981, Belize became a member of the United Nations. And the UN is a peacekeeping organization that come together to make sure that country live in peace and harmony. Then the UN is broken down into several groups. Each group has its own responsibilities to keep the UN running smoothly as a whole organization. There are currently 193 countries that are members of the United Nations, the UN. Then we have the International Court of Justice. And I'm sure that you're familiar with the ICJ, because that's where the case between Belize and Guatemala will be heard whenever Belize decided to go to the ICJ. The ICJ is the International Court of Justice that address any matter of international law. Then you know the International Court of Justice is a court that solves issues between two countries. And a good example, whenever Belize decide to vote in a referendum and we decide that we want to go to the ICJ to solve the Belize-Guatemala issue, case will go to the International Court of Justice. Then we have UNESCO. What is UNESCO? So what is the role of UNESCO? UNESCO protecting cultural diversity and biodiversity, including genetic variation, species, ecosystems, and landscapes, and securing services provided by such diversity. Then we have the International Monetary Fund, the IMF. So the International Monetary Fund, it advises its members on how to improve their economies, short-term loans to prevent financial problems. Then remember, there's an organization that I just want to talk a little bit about here in Belize. We have Oceana. Oceana, which protects our reef. Remember, the goal of Oceana is to make sure that our reef is well protected. And again, I want to thank you so much for staying tuned to today's lesson. Remember, you can subscribe for quick access to all the new lessons and videos coming soon. Thanks so much for listening. Remember to share this video and look forward for many more to come.